We're going to try a new setup, kind of have a bit of a studio setup now with a nice solid backdrop. I got some new lights. Anyway, hello, long time no see. I know I was working on a kind of like best of the decade series until I kind of, and then I'd like disappeared. In February, I actually launched my own consulting business for beauty brands. So I've been kind of busy with that, kind of have some clients, some new opportunities, and then I'm currently working on a few different projects for brands in terms of content creation. So it's been kind of busy, but I now have, I think, a better understanding of my schedule, so I can start to pepper in videos again. And this video is actually going to be my second collaboration with Trish, aka The Floraesthetic, aka Green Beauty Trish, and we're going to be doing our favorite fragrances for summer. You might have seen the collaboration we did for our favorite fall fragrances, and if you haven't, I'll link that below or I'll try to put it on the screen somewhere, and you can check that one out. And if you don't know Trish, she is a she does videos, she has an Instagram, and she has a blog, and her specialty is green beauty, plant-based products, niche fragrance. So a lot of like fragrance brands I've actually discovered through Trish. And last year we actually did a little sample swap, so there were a ton of new brands that I got to discover, so thank you, Trish. And I don't want to spoil it, but a fragrance that I really like ended up on her summer favorites, so you'll have to just watch it and check it out. So let's go ahead and start with the very first fragrance that came to mind for me, and that is Diptyque's I think it's Eau de Sens hair mist. And I actually found out about this through Bart, aka OMG Bart. He specifically shouted out the hair mist of this fragrance. So I was kind of curious because I feel like my experience with hair mist is quite limited, but this is a beautiful, sunny, sweet blend of orange blossom, orange flower, a little bit of angelica, so it kind of has like a creamy greenness to it. And then they say juniper and patchouli, although I mostly get the orange blossom. If you don't know me, I'm a huge orange blossom fan. Like, thinking about it is literally giving me shivers up my spine because I love orange blossom. To me, it just smells so happy and so sunny and so refreshing. Like, it just smells like a nice French bath product to me. And this one, compared to some of the other orange blossom fragrances I have, is on the sweeter, softer side. Sometimes I prefer orange blossom with like a bit of petit grain or a bit of woody dryness, whereas this is a lot more about the like truly refreshing, sweet nectar like sweetness from this. So what I do is I lift up half of my hair, do a little spritz, and then just let it fall. And I feel like that for me is enough fragrance to last all day. Like, if I accidentally get a whiff of my hair, I can totally smell it throughout that day and then the following morning if I haven't washed my hair that night. And I feel like it stays pretty consistent. It doesn't start to get funky or musty or musky. It really maintains this like orange blossom, fresh sweetness. So next we have SIGIL Prima Materia. And what I love about this is that it reminds me of hot, sun-soaked earth. Like, if you've been out in a garden at noon when the sun is at its highest and you get this like woody, earthy, dirty, as in soil, kind of warmth, that's what it reminds me of. The notes here are vetiver, oak moss, neroli, white sage. Maybe it's the sage interacting with the oak moss. Or maybe it's the vetiver, but I think somehow they all those notes work in unison to give this truly, like, to me, a picture of gardening at noon on a hot, hot summer day. And that's why I love it, because it's so, to me, it's so situational. It really does, like, capture a moment versus, like, you know, just a collection of notes. Yeah, I almost get this like tree bark kind of vibe where it's dry, kind of crunchy, but still has like a woody warmth to it. A dry warmth for sure. And you know, SIGIL's got that amazing magnetic cap. And if you are curious about another fragrance, Amor Fati, that was in my fall fragrances video. So I'll definitely be sure to link that as well. Okay, next we've got a newer release. This is Boy Smells Flor de la Virgen. One complaint I have, when I received this, the label, I guess when someone put the fragrance in the box, the label started to like peel up on the edge here. I don't know if you can see that. See here on the edge? which is kind of annoying. And there was this like scuff mark as well when I first took it out of the box, which is kind of disappointing. You know, you shouldn't have this kind of defect in like a $100 fragrance, but nevertheless, the juice on the inside is really good, and that's what matters. What I love about this is that it's a very gorgeous fig, ivy, jasmine blend that's super transparent, super wearable. Breezy to me is like the best word that describes this. You could just throw it on and just not really think twice about it and just know it's going to smell good. You're going to kind of smell slightly shower fresh, but have a bit of a floral kind of softness worked in. This is a much more wearable jasmine. It's a lot, like I said, more transparent, softer. Crowd pleaser is what I'd call it. Personally, I don't love the packaging. I feel like it's a little bit unnecessary. And if I'm being honest, the first time I saw it, I was like, someone just took the Byredo bottle, took the cap, put it in a CAD system, flipped it upside down, stretched it out, and called it a day. Because that's really literally what it looks like. I mean, if you put the Byredo, you know, you put this on the Byredo, it looks like a boy smells now. Surely I can't be the only one that sees the comparison. Because, you know, the cap is... You can pick... So it looks like I just proved my point there. You can't really pick it up by the cap, especially if there's any fragrance residue on the inside here, because I guess there is, like, some component in it that makes it slippery. So, yeah. See, you can't pick it up by the cap. As long as you really clean out the inside of the lid and you dry off the top of the atomizer sprayer thing, it will stay, but you just have to make sure it's dry, which means wiping the inside of the cap and the nozzle every single time, or you just end up breaking a glass dish like I just did. So it was a bit embarrassing, but also proved my point. And I did do a full review of the fragrance collection for the highlight, which I'll link below. All right, next we have a classic. We've got the Alvarez Gomez Agua de Colonia Concentrada. This is a Spanish brand, and the original Agua de Colonia came out in 1912. I think they reworked it in about 2000, and I think they've been kind of keeping up with that ever since. But this is an amazingly priced fragrance. I got this bottle at New London Pharmacy in New York, and I think this was around 20 for an 80 ml bottle. So great price. You know, you're not going to get the most wear time or projection with this. It's definitely like a classic cologne, very light, very kind of splash it on in the bathroom and go. It's lemon, bergamot, geranium, and lavender. So kind of a citrus aromatic. You definitely get like that bit of spiciness from the geranium. Like it almost leans a little gingery to me because it has a touch of warmth. But yeah, to me, it's almost like the Flor de la Virgen in that you just throw it on, don't even think about it, and just know you're going to smell good. Again, very straightforward. I think if you're maybe someone who is used to wearing essential oils or fragrance oils, I think you might really like this. You know, if you wanted to make this last longer, you could take something like just a pure skin musk, like Dead Cool Milk, spray that down first to give it something to anchor, to give this something to anchor to, and that'll really latch onto those base notes and really wear a little bit longer. But I just love the fleeting nature of this. You know, that's what I... It feels like a classic cologne in that sense, you know? Okay, next we've got one of my favorites, and that's Covet by Sarah Jessica Parker. I maintain that she makes some of the best fragrances that you can buy, celebrity or otherwise, for the price. All of her fragrances are under $100, even the large 3.4 ounce bottles are under $100. This one is 3.4, and I paid... I think they're selling it for $50, but I paid like $25 on FragranceNet years ago. And this is lavender, geranium, lemon, and chocolate on the top notes. Lily of the Valley, honeysuckle, magnolia in the middle. Musk, vetiver, teakwood, and amber in the base. Like it, to me, is almost like lavender lemonade in the garden in the morning when the ground is still damp from like the dew at night. It's lavender lemonade in the garden. That's what it is. Oh, it's so good. And don't think, like, when you think chocolate, don't think literal chocolate. It's really here to kind of give a an earthy bitterness almost to kind of just anchor the lavender and lemon down, because on their own, they could be quite, like the Alvarez Gomez, quite fleeting notes. But I think the chocolate is really what's giving it that grounded quality. And I got this actually when I got my first apartment in New York in August 2015, I want to say. I had just gotten this fragrance, I think, like right before I had moved. So like I was wearing this a lot. At this point, I treasure it and I cherish it and I don't use a lot of it because it's such a special fragrance to me, and it has set so many memories associated with it now. I don't think I've ever really smelled anything quite like this. I don't really have like a comparison to give you, but you know, definitely worth checking out. I can't say for sure if it's a safe blind buy. Like I think you might want to smell this first. I was totally, like it exceeded my expectations when I ordered it, but and I blind bought it, but yeah. I don't know. You just have to kind of know if you like those notes or not. Ooh, next we've got one of my, I guess, go-to summer fragrances, which is Byredo's Bal d'Afrique. I personally don't quite understand the Byredo hysteria. I haven't smelled a lot of the fragrances, but the ones I have, I think they're nice. But I don't know, maybe I just haven't smelled enough to really to understand like the truly mass hysteria, the hype around it. And this one is, with notes here, we've got bergamot, lemon, neroli, African marigold, buchu, heart notes, we've got violet, jasmine petals, cyclamen, base notes, we've got black amber, musk, vetiver, and Moroccan cedarwood. So this is kind of billed as a vetiver fragrance that's supposed to kind of be a celebration of 1920s Paris's obsession with African culture. Okay, I think the African marigold is what they're kind of trying to highlight here. And to be honest, I don't know that I've smelled that flower straight up to kind of be able to tell you if it captures that or not. To me, I definitely get like the lemon and the vetiver, a bit of like the jasmine and violet kind of in the background a little bit. Like to me, it's like we've got the lemon up here, we've got the vetiver here, and then we've got the violet and the jasmine kind of supporting them. But with that said, I wouldn't necessarily classify this as a straightforward vetiver fragrance, like not like Guerlain's vetiver or, oh, like a dirty grass from Heretic. Like it doesn't go that grassy, crunchy, dry, warm. It's a little bit more lemony, splashy, and the musk is definitely there. Something is giving it like a smoothness. It's nice like if you're hanging out with friends or if you're like running to the grocery store, just if you're going to be around people and you want to smell good and you want to smell good for yourself, but you also want to smell good for other people. And you know, the Byredo's got those magnetic caps as well, which I think is amazing. So those are all the fragrances that I want to mention. And then I do want to just bring up one candle, and that's the Boy Smells Italian. I don't think I can say it on YouTube. I love the classic scent. It's very like suede. To me, it's like a creamy suede that just smells like really nice furniture. I don't really get like a pot vibe from it. And same here with this. I don't really get like a pot vibe, but if you like limoncello and basil. And the thing that I really appreciate is citrus oils don't really burn all that nicely. They kind of smell a little bit weird, a little sometimes metallic when you burn them, I find. Here, I feel like they've done it in a way that really the fragrance stays true both when the wax is cold and when you're actually burning the candle. And the limoncello is there to give like that tangy kind of liqueur sweetness. And then the basil is in here just to kind of give a bit of like a cool greenness. It doesn't pull too strong because I feel like basil can sometimes lean like licorice or anise, you know, because it has kind of like a minty bitterness versus I think in here it just is, it kind of cools everything off a little bit, gives you this like kind of lush meaning like abundant kind of scent. One of the most unique candles I've smelled in a while. Very interesting to find, you know, a lemon component in here that burns nicely. So props to Boy Smells for that. And yeah, love it. So I think that's everything. I think I covered all the fragrances. So like I mentioned in the beginning, this is a collaboration with Trish. So please be sure to check out her video. It'll be linked below. Be sure to subscribe, give her a thumbs up, give her a comment. And same here, if you wouldn't mind subscribing, giving a thumbs up, leaving a comment if you'd like, that really helps me out. Hopefully it's not going to be too long before I do my next video. Now that I know what my schedule kind of looks like now, I can kind of plan these videos because I do miss it. I feel like it's a much more effective way for me to communicate my thoughts on products than like an Instagram post. So, and I haven't forgotten that I have best skincare of the decade and best hair care and fragrances of the decade to film. So that will be happening soon. I also want to do a sunscreen video. I've been trying a lot of them lately. So anyway, just let me know if any of that sounds interesting. And until my next video, I will talk to you very soon. Bye.